You are more capable than you think, but you need to start focusing on the one thing that is guaranteed to make you look better, feel better, and do better. However, this has nothing to do with cold showers, journaling, or meditation. Listen very closely, because what I am talking about is the foundation of your health and the one thing that you will do for a third of your life, sleep. I'm gonna show you 5 changes that you can improve on today so you can improve your sleep and take control of your life. But I'll also share with you the 10-3-1 rule, which for me has put getting high quality sleep autopilot. Before we get there, you need to understand a few things. Have you noticed how certain people can wake up early and immediately tackle the day, while others will press the snooze button the second that alarm starts buzzing? Or perhaps you have noticed that some people are ready to go to bed by 9 p.m. That's because of your personal circadian rhythm. Your circadian rhythm is like your own personal built-in alarm clock that helps your body know when it's time to go to sleep and when to wake up. But it isn't magic. It's influenced by things like sunlight, temperature, and your habits. For instance, when sunlight hits our bodies, they respond by producing more serotonin, which helps you feel alert and awake, and is destroying your sleep every single day. But more on that later. Inside our body and at the heart of our circadian rhythm, there are genes that make proteins go up and down, telling you when to go to sleep. However, research has shown that these genes can mutate, resulting with some people being more awake in the morning while others being more awake at night. Just think back to any movie you've seen with characters out in the wild. When one character goes to sleep, there's always somebody else staying awake and looking out for danger. And although this habit isn't necessary for living in the 21st century, it would have been essential for people living out in the wilderness. So, what does all of this have to do with you? Well, because of how we've evolved and our genetics, you might naturally feel more awake and alert either in the morning or at night. This preference is called your chronotype. There are many different types of chronotype, but the 2 most popular ones are your early bird and the night owl. On one hand, early birds will feel best in the morning. So if this is you, it is best to wake up between 6 and 8 in the morning and go to bed between 10 and 12 at night. On the other hand, night owls will feel best at night. If this is you, you should wake up between 8 and 10 in the morning and go to sleep between 12 and 2 at night. Over 90% of American adults report being addicted to caffeine. It's a drug that is so widely accepted that you will be judged if you don't use it. But make no mistake, caffeine is a drug and it can have a massive impact on your sleep if you get your dosages wrong. But why? When you enjoy your morning coffee or tea, caffeine molecules start attaching themselves to adenosine receptors in your brain. Adenosine is a chemical in your brain that helps you relax and go to sleep. Right after waking up in the morning, your adenosine levels are at the lowest. As the day goes on, your body starts to accumulate more adenosine, which is why you start feeling tired as the day progresses. When you sleep, your adenosine levels decrease, making you feel awake and refreshed in the morning. Now, going back to caffeine, when the molecules attach themselves to the adenosine receptors, it prevents the neurotransmitters from signaling to your brain that your body is tired. That's why you feel awake after having a cup of coffee, even if it's the middle of the night. However, because caffeine only lasts about 3 to 5 hours, it's also the reason why you often experience a drop of energy in the afternoon, otherwise known as the caffeine crash. What does this tell you about using caffeine? Well, according to the Journal of Clinical Sleep Medicine, consuming caffeine 6 hours before bed can lead to a delay in your natural sleep patterns. It can reduce your deep sleep and result in more sleep disruptions. And if this happens every single night, it will negatively impact not only your sleep, but your overall health. In fact, there was a study carried out in the United Kingdom covering 16 different countries, 25 years, and 100,000 deaths. The study concluded that those who slept 6 hours or less a night were 12% more likely to experience premature death compared to those that slept between 6 and 8 hours every night. So, if you're sensitive to caffeine, research shows that it is best to restrict your consumption to before 12 p.m. in the afternoon. First, consume your first dose of caffeine 2 hours after waking up. This delay allows your body to gradually increase its adenosine levels, which helps remove the afternoon crash. Second, I want you to consider switching from coffee to green tea. Green tea contains not only caffeine, but also L-theanine. It's an amino acid that helps promote a sense of calmness to counteract the stress and jitters associated to your caffeine. Third, If you find yourself particularly tired one day, try having a dose of caffeine, followed immediately by a 15-minute nap. Caffeine takes some time to be absorbed by your system, so when you wake up, you'll feel like a superhero. Fourth, you want to limit your coffee consumption. This way, if you choose to supplement with decaffeinated coffee in the evening, the smell and the taste of coffee will psychologically prime your mind for increased productivity, almost like a placebo effect. And finally, ditch the milk, creamer, and sugar and opt for black coffee or tea. Not only is this a healthier choice for your body and your waistline, but it can also support intermittent fasting, which, when combined with caffeine, has been shown to significantly increase focus. And one more thing, caffeine isn't just found in your coffee and your tea. It's also found in soda, chocolate, chewing gum, and even pain medication. So be mindful of not only your coffee and tea consumption, but your overall diet. From there, I recommend you invest in equipment that's specifically designed to help you sleep. Now, you can get the basics like earplugs or a blacked out eye mask, which according to research has been known to improve sleep quality and hormone balance. You can even invest in blackout curtains to reduce light or a dehumidifier to improve air quality. But I want to tell you about something that no one else is talking about and is clinically proven to give you fast results. You see, I wasn't always into my sleep, but in recent years, it's become one of my biggest priorities in life. And after doing my own research, I came across countless of clinical studies of how stimulating my vagus nerve can help improve my sleep quality. The vagus nerve starts in the brain and it goes all the way through the body's major organs. It controls the parasympathetic nervous system and helps regulate your heart rate, blood pressure, digestion, and respiration. But most importantly, it also plays a key role in how we handle stress and relax. I then came across a guy named Brian Johnson, which for those of you who don't know, he has been going viral recently for spending millions on himself to try to keep his youth and live as long as possible. In fact, the guy scored a 100% sleep score using a sleep tracker for an entire month. To put this into context, most people have never achieved a perfect sleep score, even after years of using a sleep tracking device. But in one of his videos, I also saw him talking about wearing a pulsetto, which is a headband-looking device which stimulates the vagus nerve. I then found out that the average user of a pulsetto reported a 35% increase in mood, a 47% increase in focus, a 27% increase in optimism, a 19% increase in calmness, and a 27% increase in sleep quality. It looks like it's out of the matrix, and you know what? It might as well be the red pill, because after the benefits I've received from using it, I'm never going back to sleeping without it. All you have to do is apply some gel to the area where your vagus nerve is located, select the program using the Bluetooth connected app, and then electrical impulses will stimulate the vagus nerve between 5 to 10 minutes to help you relax and prepare you for sleep. It has improved my sleep, and now I want it to improve yours as well. So don't hesitate. Go to the Pulsetto website using the link in my description, and then I'm going to include a specific discount code in the description for a limited time so you can enjoy the benefits as well. This product, along with earplugs, a blacked out eye mask, and blacked out curtains are now essential for my sleep, and they should be for yours as well. Remember when I said that modern light hijacks our circadian rhythm? Well, that is the reason right there. The sun is going down, and yet I stand here in a well-lit room because unless you're living in a cave, you're likely surrounded by light bulbs, light from the television, light from your electronic devices, and of course, the biggest offender of them all, your phone. All of these sources of light, including the sun, share one common trait. They produce blue light, which is one of the most powerful types of light for the human eye. And this is a problem because when the sun sets and our eyes no longer receive blue light, they begin to produce a hormone called melatonin. Melatonin is our body's way of signaling, like, hey, it's time to go to sleep. But when I'm sitting in light inside my home or staring at my phone before I go to bed, I'm tricking my brain into believing it's still daytime. Melatonin production then stops, which has been proven to result in less REM sleep and lower sleep quality. But it doesn't stop there. Blue light can also cause digital eye strain, headaches, blurred vision, and difficulty focusing. So what's the cure? Well, aside from completely ditching your devices, first, if you have an Apple device, turn on night shift. And if you have an Android, turn on night mode. This will decrease the amount of blue light coming out of your phone screen. Second, you want to invest in screen filters that stops the blue light that comes out of your phone screen. So when should you eat? Research suggests that your last meal should be at least 3 hours before bed, and ideally at the same time every day to help regulate your circadian rhythm and your hormones. The best foods to consume are those with high levels of serotonin and melatonin. Some great examples include cherry juice, dairy products, and, contrary to what most believe, simple carbs like pasta, white rice, and potatoes. These are better than slow digesting carbs like your oats. With that being said, if your room is too hot, you may find yourself waking up several times during the night. So what can you change today? Well, according to most research, taking a warm shower 90 minutes before going to bed and keeping your room temperature between 60 and 68 degrees Fahrenheit is best for achieving a good night's sleep. Now, let's talk about the 10-3-1 rule, which has completely transformed how I feel every day. It's simple. Just make sure you avoid caffeine at least 10 hours before going to bed. You want to stop eating 3 hours before going to bed, and you want to stay away from electronic devices 1 hour before going to bed. By following this rule, along with every other tip that I showed you in this video, you will be on your path to unlocking your potential and optimizing your capabilities. That's it for me today. Here are two more videos you can continue to watch to level up. See you next time.